हेलो एंड वेलकम टू लेट्स क्रैक सीबीएसई साइंस एग्जाम क्लास 12th। कैसे हैं? आगे वापस सारे के सारे? शॉर्ट ब्रेक, डिड इट हेल्प यू? ठीक था, ब्रेक तो बनता है भाई, हर किसी का बनता है। लेट्स चेक इन द चैट रूम हु ऑल आर हियर, कौन कौन आए हैं हमारे पास में, या फिर कोई ऐसा भी था जो गया ही नहीं था। गए नहीं थे बेटा तो प्लीज चले जाइए, टेक अ ब्रेक, ब्रेक तो बनता है। किटकैट, हाय भावना, हेलो, गुड इवनिंग, कैसे हो आप? हाउ आर यू? ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ आर इनफैक्ट वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विथ व्हाट वी वर डूइंग यस्टरडे। वी हैड लेफ्ट एट द प्रोज पार्ट, इज इट इट? अगर आपको याद है तो हमने कल प्रोज किया था। प्रोज के साथ में हमें क्या करना था? लेट्स क्रैक सीबीएसई साइंस करना है ना? बाकी सारी चीजें तो बाद में होती है, लेट्स क्रैक सीबीएसई फर्स्ट। सो वेलकम टू द प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ अन अकेडमी, इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट लर्निंग ऐप फॉर ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन। ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन, दिस इज द लार्जेस्ट प्लेटफॉर्म वेर यू कैन लर्न फ्रॉम एंड क्रैक योर सीबीएसई एग्जाम एंड फॉर दैट मैटर एनी कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम। वी मेक थिंग्स वेरी इजी फॉर यू। आई एम योर एजुकेटर डॉक्टर यामिनी, हुज डन ह्यूमैनिटीज पीएचडी, दैट इज पीएचडी इन इंग्लिश, एंड आई बीन इन टू टीचिंग प्रोफेशन फॉर पास्ट 15 ईयर्स। 15 साल से पढ़ा रही हूँ, बहुत सारे बच्चों से मिली हूँ, बहुत सारे बच्चों के साथ में इंटरेक्शन हुआ है मेरा, तो इट इज ऑलवेज बीन अ गुड फन। अच्छा लगता है बच्चों से मिलना, उनसे इंटरेक्ट करना। ओके, सो वी आर हियर विथ आर लाइव क्लासेस, जो आप देखना यूट्यूब पे भी होते हैं। यूट्यूब पे हमारे लाइव क्लासेस आते हैं, देन 10 PM एट नाइट आई अगेन हैव अ क्लास। डू डू ज्वाइन मी देयर। वहां पे व्हेन यू ज्वाइन यू विल फाइंड दैट आपके जैसे बहुत सारे आपके फ्रेंड्स भी हैं, आप उनके साथ इंटरेक्ट करके क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन कर सकते हो। यू कैन चैट विथ मी ऑल्सो, मेरे से बात कीजिए, मेरे से क्वेश्चन पूछिए, मैं क्वेश्चन पूछूं आप उसका आंसर दीजिए। दिस इज वॉट इंटरक्टिव क्लास इज ऑल अबाउट, लाइव टेस्ट एंड क्विजेस। जो मेरे साथ शुरू से कनेक्टेड हैं उन बच्चों को पता है, जो आज नए नए आए हैं, आपके जो फ्रेंड्स आप जिनको लेके आए हो आज, उनके लिए देयर इज अ स्मॉल इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट आई ऑलवेज हैव क्विजेस। वेन एवर आई टीच माई क्लासेस हैव क्विजेस। लाइव टेस्ट मैंने अभी शुरू नहीं किया है, विच आई विल स्टार्ट एंड देन आई विल बी पुटिंग इट ऑन टेलीग्राम ऑल्सो। तो क्विजेस और टेस्ट हम प्रोवाइड करते हैं आपको, जिससे कि आप अपना इवेल्युएशन कर सकते हो अपने प्रिपरेशन का। यू कैन इवेल्युएट वेयर यू आर स्टैंडिंग टुडे, हाउ मच ऑफ प्रिपरेशन फॉर द बोर्ड 12th पेपर हैव यू डन एंड हाउ मच इज लेफ्ट। वी हैव मॉक टेस्ट एंड क्विजेस। मॉक टेस्ट भी होते हैं तो आप उसको भी एक्सेस कर सकते हैं। वी हैव स्ट्रक्चर्ड कोर्सेज, जहाँ पे कि हम आपके एग्जाम सिलेबस के अकॉर्डिंगली स्ट्रक्चर करके प्रेजेंट करते हैं आपका सिलेबस, जो आपकी पढ़ाई को और इजी और लाइटर बनाता है। फॉर इंस्टेंस, जैसे मैंने जब ये सेशन शुरू किया था वहाँ पे, इफ यू रिमेम्बर, जो मेरे पास अगेन जो पहले से हैं, शुरू से है मेरे साथ में, दे वुड नो। भावना इज हियर, लेट्स रेस्पॉन्ड। ओके, तो जो मेरे साथ हैं बेटा उनको पता है, जो नए आए हैं उनके लिए हमारे कोर्सेज, जैसे मैंने बोला आपको शुरू में जब मैंने आपके साथ क्लासेस स्टार्ट करी थी उसमें मैंने आपको बताया था, आई हैड टोल्ड यू कि इस बारी हमने अपना जो सिलेबस है वो रिवाइज किया है ना, सीबीएसई ने सिलेबस रिवाइज किया है। तो हमने अपना सिलेबस अकॉर्डिंगली रिवाइज किया है और उसमें हम शुरुआत में वही टॉपिक्स ले रहे हैं, बी इट योर लैंग्वेज, बी इट योर राइटिंग स्किल और बी इट योर लिटरेचर। हम पहले वो कवर करेंगे जो आपके क्लास 12th बोर्ड पेपर में आएगा एंड विल बी डूइंग एग्जैक्टली ऑन द सेम पैटर्न। एंड देन यू हैव अनलिमिटेड एक्सेस। आपके पास अनलिमिटेड एक्सेस होता है, यू जस्ट हैव टू सब्सक्राइब फॉर वन कोर्स। आप एक कोर्स के लिए सब्सक्राइब कीजिए एंड देन यू विल गेट बेनिफिट ऑफ स्टडिंग ऑल द सब्जेक्ट्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आप मेरा रेफरल कोड यूज कीजिए, विच इज YAMINI1। रेफरल कोड आप यूज करेंगे और उसके बाद में आपको एक्सेस मिलेगा फॉर ऑल द सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ साइंस दैट यू हैव चोजन। आपको अलग अलग सब्जेक्ट्स के लिए अलग अलग सब्सक्राइब नहीं करना है। देन वी हैव लाइव क्लासेज, वी गिव यू फ्री लाइव क्लासेज ऑल्सो, जहाँ पे कि ये हमारे एजुकेटर्स हैं जिनके साथ आप पढ़ सकते हैं और अपना डाउट क्लियरिंग सेशन भी रख सकते हैं। लाइक आई टोल्ड यू, आपका एक सब्सक्रिप्शन आपको ये सारे सब्जेक्ट्स में एक्सेस देगा, मैथ्स, फिजिक्स, बायो केमिस्ट्री, इकोनॉमिक्स। एंड हाउ डू यू डू इट, यू जस्ट हैव टू इंस्टॉल द अनअकैडमी लर्निंग ऐप. आप अनअकैडमी लर्निंग ऐप को इंस्टॉल कीजिए. व्हेन यू इंस्टॉल इट, यू कम टू दिस पेज जहाँ पे इट आस्क यू टू गेट सब्सक्रिप्शन. आप सब्सक्रिप्शन क्यों लोगे, आई विल टेल यू आप सब्सक्रिप्शन क्यों लीजिए. सब्सक्रिप्शन लेने से वॉट डू यू गेट, यू गेट 30+ आवर्स ऑफ लाइव सेशन एवरी डे. हर दिन आपको 30+ आवर्स के लाइव सेशन मिलते हैं. स्ट्रक्चर्ड कोर्सेज इन इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी, हमारे कोर्सेज इंग्लिश में है, एक्सक्लूसिवली इंग्लिश. वी हैव क्लासेस इन हिंदी एज वेल, सो वी आर बाइलिंगुअल ऑल्सो. 14+ टॉप एजुकेटर्स आर देयर ऑन आवर प्लेटफॉर्म जिसके साथ आप पढ़ सकते हैं. एंड देन वी हैव न्यू कोर्सेज पब्लिश्ड एवरी मंथ. सो दीज आर द बेनिफिट्स यू गेट वंस यू सब्सक्राइब विद अनअकैडमी. सो डोंट वेट फॉर इट एंड जॉइन फास्ट. We are also there on Telegram app. The link given over here, which you can see on the screen, you just have to put this link here. आप link यहाँ पे डालिए and then link type करने के बाद join click कीजिए and there you are. यहाँ पे आपको quizzes, mock tests, notes, we provide you everything that is necessary for your 12th standard class and exam. Then come and prepare with our top educators. These are the top educators जिनके आप recorded class भी देख सकते हैं या फिर आप इनके साथ में direct live classes में connect कर सकते हैं. Special classes, plus classes, you can connect anywhere with these and then you are good to go. Be a part of the learning community and excel. How do you do it? कैसे करोगे आप? Of course easy है. We have these time frame courses, but I suggest you go for this one. 12th का paper है, crucial time of your career है ये. यहाँ से आपका career shape करने वाला है. So आप 12 months का course subscribe कीजिए. The charges are 12,500, but you don't have to pay this 12,500. What are you supposed to do? आपने YAMINI referral code है ये मेरा. Referral code type कीजिए. बॉक्स में इसको आप ऐड कीजिए, अप्लाई कीजिए एंड देन सब्सक्राइब फॉर 12 मंथ्स कोर्स फॉर लेट्स क्रैक सीबीएसई साइंस. एंड देन हाउ मच डू यू पे, यू डोंट पे 12,500, यू पे 11,250 ओनली. एंड देन नथिंग एल्स टू बी डन, आप हमारे प्रोग्राम में एडेड हो और हम हैं आपके पढ़ाई में आपकी हेल्प करने के लिए. So Vistas, this is what we have been discussing. The chapter is pretty long. It's an elaborate chapter. Chapter ka naam kya hai? Jaldi batao, who will write? Yes, Bhavna, this is 1 hour session. And this is 1 hour session, Bhavna. Hum yahan 1 hour ka session kar rahe hain. Humne kal jo kiya tha, the enemy, humne kal start kari thi. We are going to continue with that only. हम वही पढ़ेंगे. The enemy. What happens in the chapter? It is written by Pearl S. Buck, ठीक है, जो कि अमेरिकन राइटर थी, नॉवलिस्ट थी. ये उनका एक पॉपुलर स्टोरी है विच हैज बीन एडेड इन योर विस्टा सप्लीमेंट्री रीडर. एंड दिस इज द कवर पेज, जो कि आपके स्टोरी का कवर पेज है. द सेटिंग यू कैन सी इट इज अबाउट जापानीज कपल. जापानीज कपल है यहाँ पे. ही इज द डॉक्टर एंड शी इज हिज वाइफ एंड दिस इज द एनिमी दैट दे गॉट नियर देयर डोर स्टेप. ठीक है, उनके घर के थोड़ी दूर पे, नॉट एग्जैक्टली द डोर स्टेप, उनके घर के थोड़ी दूर पे ये उनको मिला था जिसकी इन्होंने जान बचाई. एंड देन फर्दर विल डिस्कस व्हाट हैपेंस इन द स्टोरी. वी हैड डिस्कस्ड ऑल दीज थिंग्स इन द प्रीवियस क्लास. ओके, सो विल मूव फर्दर. Now, your quiz here. The name of the main character in The Enemy is? Yes, Bhavna, tell me, who is the main character in The Enemy? Dr. Hauchi, Dr. Huyen Sang, Dr. Chungwa or Dr. Sadao Hoki? Who is the main character? Quickly. We will be starting with, if you have your Vistas book with you, yesterday we had covered till page number 27. हमने 27 page number तक कर लिया था. So we'll be starting with page number 28. तो आप बेटा फटाफट अपना page number 28 open कीजिए and be ready. हम वहां से discussion करेंगे. Yes, Dr. Sadao, thank you. Next question. Those islands yonder, they are the stepping stones to the future for Japanese words were spoken by Sadao's वाइफ, नेफ्यू, मदर, फादर. इफ यू हैव रेड द स्टोरी, अगर आप कल की क्लास में भी थे तो यू विल इमीडिएटली रिकलेक्ट करो, बिकॉज लिटरेचर इज अबाउट रिकलेक्टिंग. आपके एग्जामिनर को आपका रिकलेक्शन स्किल्स से तो देखना है, ये बिगिनिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर में था, दिस वॉज इन द वेरी फर्स्ट पेज ऑफ योर चैप्टर द एनिमी, किसने बोला था ये? दोज आइलैंड योंडर दे आर द स्टेपिंग स्टोन्स टू द फ्यूचर ऑफ जापानीज वर्ड्स वर स्पोकन बाय, बताओ किसने बोला था? Who said these words? Yes, I'm waiting for an answer. Who said so? किसने बोला? जल्दी बताइए. No, Bhavna. It's not the wife. It is the father. फादर है ये, ठीक है, इट्स द फादर, गुड ट्राई, थैंक यू सो मच. द चीफ कंसर्न ऑफ सादाओज फादर वॉज, क्या था? वेडिंग ऑफ सादाओ, सादाओज माइग्रेशन, सादाओज ट्रीटमेंट और सादाओज एजुकेशन, विच वॉज द मेन कंसर्न फॉर सादाओज फादर? इफ यू रिमेंबर, ही वॉज नॉट अ वेरी फ्रेंडली फादर, बट ही वॉज वेरी मच कंसर्न एंड पर्टिकुलर अबाउट सादाओज फ्यूचर. तो क्या था उनका कंसर्न? शादी? नहीं, इट वॉज सादाओज एजुकेशन. Okay, we'll move to the next one. See, we have done till here. These are the questions. What did Dr. Sadao's father tell him? Ye sara humne kal kar liya tha. Okay, now, so we are going to start from here. Like I told you that yesterday we had done till page number 27. Humne kya kiya tha? I'll give you a quick sum up. मैं आपको एक छोटा सा रिकैप इसका दे देती हूँ. व्हाट हैड हैपेंड, डॉक्टर सादाओ, द स्टोरी स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम अ फ्लैशबैक जहाँ पे दिखाया जाता है डॉक्टर सादाओ वाज अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड. बचपन से शुरू होती है कहानी. डॉक्टर सादाओ इज शोन एज अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड हु इज स्टैंडिंग एट नियर हिज हाउस विच इज ऑन द बीच, एंड उस बीच से एक आइलैंड दिखाई देता है. सो देयर सादाओ एज अ चाइल्ड इज स्टैंडिंग विद हिज फादर, एंड द फादर इज वेरी केयरिंग पर्सन. वो अपने बेटे को बताते हैं, एंड ही वॉज अ ट्रू पेट्रियट ऑल्सो. सो वो अपने बेटे को बोलते हैं दैट द आइलैंड ओवर देयर इज गोइंग टू चेंज द फ्यूचर ऑफ जापान वन डे. और फिर व्हेन सादाओ ग्रोज अप एंड ही रीचेज द एज ऑफ 22, ही इज सेंट टू अमेरिका टू स्टडी मेडिसिन बिकॉज द फादर वॉन्टेड टू सी सादाओ एज अ डॉक्टर. सादाओ ग्रोज ओनली नॉट एज अ मेडिकल प्रोफेशनिस्ट, ही ऑल्सो डेवलप ग्रोज एज अ साइंटिस्ट, वो साइंटिस्ट भी बनते हैं. एंड देन एट द एज ऑफ 30 ही कम्स बैक टू जापान. वर्ल्ड वॉर टू के बैकग्राउंड में सेट है हमारी स्टोरी जो मैंने आपको बताया था. क्या होता है वर्ल्ड वॉर टू के टाइम पे, वहां पे जापानीज यंग मैन वर बीइंग इंडक्टेड इन द आर्मी और उनको ट्रूप को फाइट के लिए, वॉर के लिए भेजा जा रहा था. बट डॉक्टर सादाओ वॉज नॉट सेंट फॉर द सेम रीजन बींग, जो वहाँ जनरल था इनका, ही वॉज इन हिज ओल्ड एज, उसको कुछ मेडिकल प्रॉब्लम थी जिसका ट्रीटमेंट चल रहा था, एंड ही वुड नीड सर्जरी. तो उसके लिए उसको होल्ड पे रख दिया गया. सादाओ वॉज स्टॉप, ही वॉज केप्ट इन जापान, रीजन बींग द जनरल मे नीड हिम एनी टाइम. प्लस सादाओ वॉज डेवलपिंग अ साइंटिफिक ट्रीटमेंट फॉर क्लियरिंग अप ऑफ वूंड्स, और इसके लिए ही जनरल उसको चाहता था कि उसका जब ऑपरेशन हो, सादाओ इज देयर टू डू द ऑपरेशन एंड टू टेक केयर ऑफ हिम. वन इवनिंग व्हाट हैपेंस दैट व्हेन दे आर स्टैंडिंग, दैट इज सादाओ एंड हिज वाइफ हाना, दे वर कॉलेज मेट्स और इनकी शादी हो गई थी बाद में. सो व्हेन दे वर स्टैंडिंग इन द बालकनी, व्हाट हैपेंस कि उनको सी शोर से वॉश ऑफ होके एक आदमी आता हुआ मिला. When they go close to that man, they find that he is an American sailor, जो कि यहाँ पे float होके आ गया. He was a prisoner of war, और वो float होके इनके पास आ गया है. And what the couple does is, उस time पे तो वो बहुत परेशान हो जाते हैं, because the man was bleeding profusely, बहुत ज़्यादा blood निकल रहा था, because उसको एक gun shot लगा हुआ था, and he was beaten and tortured also. So this couple couldn't understand कि उसको करना क्या चाहिए. Should they throw him to the sea back, or should they take him inside, because taking him inside might declare this couple as traitor, because it was Japan and America, where Japan was leading that time. तो दे वर इन अ फिक्स वॉट टू डू एंड वॉट नॉट टू डू, और उसी टाइम पे कुछ और डिसाइड करने से पहले जब सादाओ सॉ द बैड कंडीशन ऑफ दिस बॉय, ही डिसाइडेड टू गिव हिम ट्रीटमेंट. और वो ट्रीटमेंट करने से पहले उनको दिखाई दे रहा था कि इसको कितनी इंजरी हुई है, एंड ऑटोमेटिकली सादाओज हैंड स्टार्टेड गिविंग सम काइंड ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट टू दिस फेलो. तो यहाँ तक की बात थी टिल पेज नंबर 27 में बेटा. सो वील मूव फर्दर एंड वील मूव टू पेज नंबर 28. ही पैक्ड, सो दिस इज योर पार्ट टू. He packed the wound with the sea moss that strewed the beach. Here, any where you feel कि आपको कोई वर्ड नहीं समझ में आ रहा है, डू ड्रॉप अ मैसेज इन द चैट बॉक्स और मुझे बताइएगा. ओके, द वुंड विद द सी मॉस दैट स्ट्रूड द बीच, द मैन मोन्ड विद पेन इन हिज स्टुपर बट ही डिड नॉट अवेकन. सो क्या होता है, उसकी वुंड को, उसकी जो चोट थी उसको सादाओ ने कैसे हील करने की कोशिश करी, कैसे रिपेयर करने की कोशिश करी, सी मॉस जो था जो कि पूरे बीच पे फैला हुआ था उसको लेके उन्होंने इमिडिएटली उसके वुंड पे डालने की कोशिश की. ऑब्वियसली द मैन वॉज बैडली इंजर्ड, तो उसकी मोनी की आवाज आने लग गई, वो कराहने लग गया. द बेस्ट थिंग दैट वी कुड डू वुड बी टू पुट हिम बैक इन द सी, सादाओ सेड आंसरिंग हिमसेल्फ. सादाओ इज सेल्फ टॉकिंग, खुद से बात कर रहा है और बोल रहा है कि यहाँ पे सबसे अच्छा ये होगा कि हम इसको वापस समुंदर में छोड़ दें. नाउ दैट द ब्लीडिंग वाज स्टॉप्ड फॉर द मोमेंट ही स्टूड अप एंड डस्टेड द सैंड फ्रॉम हिज हैंड. खड़ा होके उसने डस्ट को हटाया अपने हाथों से और ब्लीडिंग को रोक ली थी उसने फॉर द टाइमिंग. यस अनडाउटेडली दैट वुड बी बेस्ट, हाना सेड स्टेडिली, बट शी कंटिन्यू टू स्टेयर डाउन एट द मोशनलेस मैन. तो उसकी वाइफ ने भी सेकेंड किया, उसकी वाइफ ने भी इस चीज के साथ अग्री किया that these people, the couple should be doing this. उनको ये कर देना चाहिए, समुंदर में वापस इसको डाल देना चाहिए. If we sheltered a white man in our house, we should be arrested. And if we turned him over as a prisoner, he would certainly die. So this was the fix. This was the conflict which was there. ये conflict आप देखो story में conflict यहीं से start हो जाती है. दैट अगर वो उसको अपने घर में रख लेते, इफ दिस कपल हैड केप्ट दिस प्रिजनर ऑफ वॉर इन देयर हाउस, द कपल वुड हैव बीन अरेस्टेड एंड डिक्लेयर ट्रेटर. एंड इफ दे हैड टर्न्ड हिम ओवर एज प्रिजनर, दे वुड हैव टॉर्चर्ड हिम टू डेथ, दिस टाइम तो फॉर श्योर. द काइंडेस्ट थिंग वुड बी टू पुट हिम बैक इन टू द सी. सो हाना सेड दैट कि यू कैन सी द काइंड हार्टेड फीमेल हियर, that she did not want the prisoner to get into or to go through any kind of torture further. So she said that the best thing here to help this man would be to put him back into the sea. But neither of them moved. They were staring with a curious repulsion upon the inert figure. Inert figure is the motionless man. Idea to dono ne de diya ek dusre ko, but kisi se bhi ye cheez ho nahi rahi thi. The kindest thing would be, okay, what is he? Hana whispered, there is something about him that looks American, Sadao said. He took up the battered cap, jo uska phata hua sa cap tha, usko usne, Sadao ne uthaya. He was suspecting this prisoner of war to be an American. Cap uthaya, yes, there. Almost gone was the faint lettering, a sailor. So what did the cap read? It read, a sailor. He said, from an American warship. Aur kahan ka sailor tha wo? Kisi American warship ka sailor tha wo. He spelled it out, U.S. Navy. The man was a prisoner of war. So now the identity of this American sailor, this prisoner of war is revealed here. First thing is, he was an identity of this prisoner of war is American. Then he is a sailor. He comes from American warship, which spells US Navy. Okay, so now we know about this prisoner of war. He was an American sailor from US Navy warship. Okay, he has escaped, Hana cried softly, and that is why he is wounded. Obviously usne bhagne ki koshish kari to usko goli maar di gayi thi, in the back. Sadao agreed. To kahan usko goli lagi thi? Usko goli lagi thi uski back mein. They hesitated, looking at each other. Then Hannah said, with resolution, "Come, are we able to put him back into the sea?" "If I am able, are you?" Sadao asked. Okay, so ये बहुत deep सा एक statement आता है यहाँ पे that Hannah was determined. She said, "Come, are we able to put him back into the sea? Let's see if we can put him back into the sea." But Sadao said, "If I am able, अगर मैं कर पाऊंगा तो तुम कर पाओगे क्या?" It is a question raised on humanity कि क्या इस इंसान को हम छोड़ पाएंगे unattended? No, Hannah said. But if you can do it alone, Sadao hesitated again. The strange thing is, he said, that if the man were whole, I could turn him over to the police without difficulty. Whole means कि अगर ये इंसान ठीक ठाक होता तब. I can nothing for him because of course he is an American and he is enemy of Japan. So any enemy of Japan is enemy of the resident over there. This is what he's saying. He is my enemy. All Americans are my enemy. Remember, Sadao's father was a true patriot. He was a true follower of his country. So same thing had grew up in Sadao also. So for him, Americans were his enemy. And he is only a common fellow. You see how foolish his face is. But since he is wounded, you also cannot throw him back to the sea, Hannah said. Then there is only one thing to do. We must carry him into the house. So finally, they come to the conclusion that since the prisoner of war is wounded, it would be so inhuman to throw him unattended or to hand him over to the police. So they decided that now they don't have any choice. They will have to carry him back into the house. But the servants, Sadao inquired, that they had servants also. They had three servants. So beginning of the chapter, mein beta, you must have, if you're not seen it, लिंक है आपके स्क्रीन पे, लिंक दिया होगा ठीक है. माय नेम इज देयर, इट इज डॉक्टर यामिनी. उससे एड्रेस एक यामिनी क्यूटन करके एक लिंक है, आप उस लिंक पे क्लिक करो. अभी तक का जो भी मैंने एक्सप्लेन किया है, द एंटायर मटेरियल इज देयर. यू कैन रेफर टू द मटेरियल एंड अंडरस्टैंड द प्रीवियस एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑल्सो. आप प्रीवियस एक्सप्लेनेशन भी चेक कर सकते हैं बेटा. We must simply tell them that we intend to give him to the police, as indeed we must, Sadao. So he says that when Sadao asked that there are servants in the house, wouldn't they retaliate? So Hannah told him that we'll tell the servants that we intend to hand over this man to police, which they should definitely. We must think of the children and your position. It would endanger all of us if we did not give this man over as a prisoner of war. So Hannah was, they had, this couple had two children. Okay, so Hannah was worried about husband, herself and children also. So she said that it is a must that we hand over this man to police as prisoner of war. That would be safe for everybody, all of them. Certainly, Sadao agreed. I would not think of doing anything else. Thus agreed, together they lifted the man. So फिर यही decide करके उन्होंने उस आदमी को उठाया. He was very light, like a fowl that had been half starved for a long time until it is only feathers and skeleton. So what happened? This man was very weak. When he was lifted by the couple, he appeared to be really weak, weak in the sense that he was not given food for a long time. He was left only with the skin and skeleton. This is how it appeared. So his arms hanging, they carried him up the steps and into the side door of the house. This door opened into a passage, and down the passage they carried the man towards an empty bedroom. It had been the bedroom of Sadao's father. Since his death, it had not been used. They led the man on the deeply matted floor. Everything here had been Japanese to please the old man, who would never in his own home sit on a chair or sleep in a foreign bed. Anna went to the wall, cupboards, and slid back a door and took out a soft quilt. She hesitated. The quilt was covered with flowered silk and the lining was pure white silk. So what happens? Finally, the prisoner of war, his name has not been mentioned here, so we'll address him as prisoner of war only or American. This American man was taken inside Dr. Sadao's house. And where was he kept? He was taken to Sadao's late father's bedroom, which was not used after Sadao's father's death. So he was put there on the matted floor because Sadao's father never sat on any chair or he never used any foreign bed. This was his principle. He was a very strong believer, I told you, believer and follower of Japanese culture. So he followed that lifestyle only. So he was laid on the matted floor, and then Hana goes, opens the cupboard, takes a soft quilt, but she was hesitant in putting that soft quilt because the man was very dirty, and this quilt was extremely beautiful, made of white silk. "He is so dirty," she murmured in distress. "Yes, he'd better be washed," Sadao agreed. "If you will fetch hot water, I will wash him. I cannot bear for you to touch him," she said. "We shall have to tell the servants he's here. I will tell Yumi now. She can leave the children for a few minutes and she can wash them." So what happens? There are three servants in this house. There is a cook, there is Yumi, the housekeeper, and there is one gardener. So when it comes to cleaning of this American man, so what does Hana say? Hana says that she wouldn't want her husband to clean this prisoner. She would better go and call the servant, and the servant will do the needful. The servant will clean this dirty man so that they can treat him and give him proper bedding also. This is what it was. Okay. To which Sadao agreed. But the utter pallor of the man's unconscious face moved him first to stoop and feel his pulse. But the current status, the bad status of this man, made Sadao bend and check his pulse first, whether the man was alive or not. It was faint, but it was there. He put his hand against the man's cold breast. The heart too was yet alive. So the man, he was very weak, wounded, but he was alive. "He will die unless he is operated on," Sadao said. "Considering the question is whether he will not die anyway." So Sadao is talking and he's saying that if this man is not operated, he's not going to survive. The chances are not at all for this man to survive without operation. The question is whether he will not die anyway. So another question is that is there any way in which he can be saved? If he's operated, there's no guarantee that the operation would be successful. And if the operation is successful, they will have to hand him over to the Japanese police. And then again, there would be a big question mark on his staying alive or survival. Hana cried out in fear, "Don't try to save him. What if he should live? What if he should die?" So Hana did not want to save this man because she did not want him alive. She did not want this man to undergo so much of torture and suffering once he was saved and handed over to police. So, and Sadao was not agreeing on this, that he did not want to leave the man unattended without operation and let him die just like that. So questions. What did the author say that Dr. Sadao was also... Why did the author say that Dr. Sadao was also famous as a scientist? चलिए मैंने आपको बोला था ना, मैं आपको हमेशा बोलती हूँ या तो क्विज होगा या तो क्वेश्चंस होंगे. अब आ जाइए हम क्वेश्चंस करते हैं बेटा, और कुछ क्वेश्चंस के आंसर आप दोगे मुझे. ओके, वेयर आर वी, वी कहाँ गए? चलो बेटा क्वेश्चन के आंसर्स करो. व्हाई डिड द ऑथर से दैट सादाओ वाज आल्सो फेमस एज अ साइंटिस्ट? क्यों बोला था ऑथर ने? सेकेंड पेज का क्वेश्चन है, फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ में इसका आंसर है. The author said that Sadao was a scientist because Sadao was also developing an expertise on operating and full treatment of wounds. उसको वो इस तरह से ट्रीट करके और हील कर सकता था दैट इट अपियर टू बी ऑलमोस्ट क्लीन. वॉट इम्प्रेशन डू यू फॉर्म ऑफ जनरल तकीमा? जनरल तकीमा इफ वी दैट यू विल कम अक्रॉस लेटर. वॉट हैपन ऑन द सेवेंथ डे? This again later, and why did servants leave Mr. Sadao's house? Okay, so we'll continue from here. Next page. Down on the motionless man. This man must have extraordinary vitality, or he should have been dead by now. So Sadao is impressed to see how strong this man was, because even after so much of torture, pain, and injury, he was. But then he was young, perhaps not even 25. So this man was really young. You mean die from operation? Hana asked. Yes. Hana considered this doubtfully, and when she did not answer, Sadao turned away. At any rate, something must be done with him out of the room. He went quickly out of the room and Hana came behind him. So now Sadao was determined that whatever may happen, he will definitely treat this man. He is going to do something for this man. He will not and he cannot sit and watch this man die gradually. Okay. He leaves the room and Hana comes behind him. She did not wish to be left alone with the white man. Though the man was motionless, he was unconscious, but Hana was not comfortable, so she left the room and she came out. She did not wish to be left alone with the white man. He was the first she had seen since she left America, and now he seemed to have nothing to with those whom she had known there. Okay, remember I told you initially also that Hana and Dr. Sadao were studying at the same professor in America. So Hana was also in Hana met Sadao in America only, and from there they had come. But once she had come back from America, she had never met any American. This was for the first time after that. Neither she was interested in meeting Americans. Here he was her enemy. To her also, this man was an enemy, a menace, living or dead. Doesn't matter to her. She turned to the nursery and called Yumi. Yumi was taking care of children. But the children heard her voice and she had to go in for a moment and smile at them and play with the boy who was nearly 3 months old. So the second baby was 3 months old and Yumi was taking care of the baby. Over the baby's soft black hair, she motioned with her mouth. Yumi, come with me. Now, if you remember, she had gone to call Yumi for washing the injured man. She calls Yumi. She went with Yumi into the bedroom next to the nursery and stood with the boy in her arms while Yumi spread the sleeping quilts on the floor and led the baby between them. So they were still practicing the same thing which the father was practicing. That is, the child's grandfather was practicing. They were sleeping on matted floor only. So Yumi is trying to make bed for the baby, and then Hana would put him to sleep. Then Hana led the way quickly and softly to the kitchen. The two servants were frightened at what their master had just told him. Sadao had already briefed the servants about. Yumi was left. The old gardener, who was also a house servant, pulled a few hairs on his upper lip. So this is a gesture of showing that he was not comfortable. The gardener had his own opinion about what Sadao and Hana wanted to do and what they had done so far. The master ought not to heal the wound of this white man. So the gardener says that Sadao shouldn't heal the wound of this white man. He said bluntly to Hana, the white man ought to die. The white man should die. First he was shot. Then the sea caught him and wounded him with her rocks. If the master heals what the gun did and what the sea did, they will take revenge on us. They here refers to nature. The gardener was a superstitious man, and he, because of which he says that he was shot once, and then when he reached the sea also did not show any mercy. She wounded him with her rocks. Now, if the master heals, something bad is going to occur to them also, because sea will take revenge on them. Okay. I will tell him what you say, Hannah replied courteously. But she herself was also frightened, although she was not superstitious as the old man. Okay, these words made her a little frightened, which she did not express. Could it ever be well to help an enemy? This is what she was afraid, what she was afraid of. She was not superstitious, but she was afraid that what would happen to them if this thing, if the word spread and people come to know that they are hiding and treating an American prisoner of war. Nevertheless, she told Yumi to fetch the hot water and bring it to the room where the white man was. Still, she continued with what they had decided, and the hot water was asked for. She went ahead and slid back the partitions. Sada was not yet there. Yumi, following, put down her wooden bucket. Then she went over to the white man. When she saw him, her thick lips folded themselves into stubbornness. I have never washed a white man, she said, and I will not wash so dirty a one now. So the moment Yumi saw that there was a white man in their house and she was supposed to wash that white man, she immediately refused. She said she's never done that and she will never do this today also. Hannah cried at her severely, you will do what your master commands you. So Hannah lost her temper and very strictly and loudly she said that Yumi had to follow her master's command, which is Sadao. There was so fierce a look of resistance upon Yumi's round, dull face that Hannah felt unreasonably afraid. But Yumi did not budge. In fact, expression was such that Hannah got afraid for some time. After all, if the servant should report something, that was not as it happened. So the fear was that if the servants get angry and upset, they may report it to the people and the police. Very well, she said with dignity. You understand, we only want to bring him to his senses so that we can turn him over as a prisoner. So she's trying to convince Yumi that their only purpose of saving this man is so that once the man recovers, they can hand it over to police. I will have nothing to do with it, Yumi said. I am a poor person and it is not my business. So Yumi still did not agree to watch the man. She said that that's none of her business. She was not going to help. Then please, Hannah said gently, return to your own work. Then Hannah was helpless. She told Yumi to go and do rest of the work. At once, Yumi left the room. But this left Hannah with the white man alone. She might have been too afraid to stay had not her anger at Yumi's stubbornness now sustained her. But now Hannah, who was initially afraid of the white man, was still motionless. She had no choice. Stupid Yumi, she muttered fiercely. Is this anything but a man and a wounded, helpless man? Now she's cursing. She's getting annoyed at Yumi also. In the conviction of her own superiority, she bent impulsively and untied the knotted rugs that kept the white man covered. So she untied the rug which was over the man's body. When she had his breast bare, she dipped the small clean towel that Yumi had brought into the steaming hot water and washed his face carefully. So what happens? That Hannah saw that there was no choice. Yumi had not agreed, but Hannah, being a dedicated wife, she would be helping her husband. So she herself starts cleaning this man. When she cleans his face, she finds the man's skin, though rough with exposure, was of a fine texture and must have been very blonde when he was a child. So this is what she notices. While she was thinking these thoughts, though not really liking the man better now that he was no longer a child, she kept on washing him until his upper body was quite clean, but she dared not turn him over. Why? Usko kyun nahi palta? She did not turn him over because this is where he was injured. Jahan usko wo bullet laga tha, jahan usko wo goli lagi thi. Where was Sadao? Now her anger was ebbing and she was anxious again and she rose, wiping her hands on the wrong towel. Then lest the man be chilled, she put the quilt over him. So she was waiting for Sadao and she saw that nobody was there. Sadao had not come back. She had cleaned the man's upper body. So she called for Sadao softly. He had been about to come in when she called. His hand had been on the door and now he opened it. So Sadao has already been on his way to this room. He saw that he had brought his surgeon's emergency bag and that he wore his surgeon's coat. So where had... Okay, so one question comes here. I can frame a question और आपको ये question मिल भी सकता है, maybe from the reference to the context से आपको ये question मिल जा सकता है बेटा, that where was Sadao when Khanna was cleaning this American prisoner? Where had Sadao gone? और what had Sadao gone for? एक question आपका बन सकता है कि Sadao था कहाँ in the meanwhile? Okay, so the answer would be that he had gone to get his surgeon's emergency bag and his surgeon's coat. So while Hannah was cleaning the American, Sadao had gone to get his surgeon's emergency bag and his surgeon's coat. Okay, you have decided to operate. Okay, another question here is why was Sadao wearing a surgeon coat and carrying his surgeon's emergency bag? The answer would be, क्या होगा आंसर बेटा बोलो, बताओ what could be the answer? Yes, the answer will be that he had decided to operate on the prisoner. Yes, he said shortly. He turned his back to her and unfolded a sterilized towel upon the floor of the Tokonama alcove and put his instrument upon it. Okay, तो क्या क्या इन्होंने, he opened his sterilized towel और उसको अपने Tokonama alcove. Tokonama alcove is an area, जैसे आप यहाँ पे देखना an okay, a niche or an alcove in a Japanese home for displaying a flower arrangement. ठीक है, एक ये area होता है Japanese home में जहाँ पे कि flower arrangement को display करते हो आप. I'll show you the picture also. But for now, we'll complete this one. Okay, you've decided to operate, she cried. Yes, he said shortly. Okay, now fetch towels. He takes his wife to get towels. She went obediently, but how anxious now, to the linen shelves and took out the towels. There ought also to be old pieces of matting so that the blood would not ruin the fine floor covering. So it was a nice Japanese house and with the flooring, floored with the good quality, beautiful mats. So she did not want to spoil them. What she is doing? She got old pieces of mat. She went to the back veranda where the gardener kept strips of matting with which to protect delicate shrubs on cold nights and took an armful of them. So she collects mats and she comes to the room. But when she went back into the room, she saw this was useless. The blood had already soaked through the packing in the man's wound and had ruined the mat under. और उसके लिए लेट हो गया था, वो मैट उनका ऑलरेडी खराब हो चुका था. Oh, the mat, she cried. Yes, it is ruined, Sadao replied. Sadao ने बोला कि हाँ ये खराब हो चुका है. Help me to turn him, he commanded her. She obeyed him without a word and began to wash the man's back carefully. Yumi would not wash him, she said. Did you wash him then? Sadao asked, not stopping for a moment, his swift, concise movements. Yes, he did not seem to hear her, but she was used to his absorption when he was at work. So, yahan pe ek chota sa conversation hota hai. Where she tells her husband that the maid had refused to wash the man. So the man, the husband understood that it was Yumi who had cleaned the upper part. And his back, jo hai, wo Dr. Sadao himself was cleaning. So questions. What did Dr. Sadao seek from Hana while operating on the wounded white man? So operation karne ke time pe, usse pehle Sadao ne kya manga tha Hana se? So it was towels that he had asked for. What happened on the seventh day? This will be later part. Okay. So we'll continue from here. He did not seem to hear her. She wondered for a moment if it mattered to him what was the body upon which he worked so long, and it was for the work he did so excellently. तो हाना को पता था, वंस द डॉक्टर इज अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन हिज वर्क, नो मैटर आप पास में कुछ भी बोलते रहो, वो उसको सुनने में नहीं आएगा. You will have to give the anesthetic if he needs it because it is going to be a surgery. Pain होने वाला था. Doctor knew it. So उसने बोला हाना को to be ready that she may have to give anesthesia to the man. I, she repeated blankly. But never have I. It is easy enough, he said impatiently. Doctor ke paas time nahi tha. He wanted to save this man as fast as possible. So he said ki koi baat nahi. Hana was reluctant because she's never done that. So he said ki nahi koi baat nahi, ho jayega. He was taking out the packing now. So jo uske wound pe packing thi, wo usko nikal raha tha. And the blood began to flow more quickly. Obviously, it was a deep wound. Chot kafi lagi thi usme. तो उससे ब्लड आना शुरू हो गया. ही पियर्ड इन टू द वुड विद अ ब्राइट सर्जन्स लाइट फास्टन ऑन हिज फोरहेड. तो इफ यू कैन सी द इमेज ओवर हियर, अगर आप ये इमेज देख रहे हो तो यहाँ पे ये देखना, दिस इज द लाइट दैट ही इज बेरिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज द लाइट दैट ही इज वेयरिंग. ये यहाँ पे हेडबैंड के जैसे टाइड है. एंड ही इज वेयरिंग व्हाट यू विल फाइंड, पहले डेंटिस्ट भी पहनते थे. ओके, सो द बुलेट इज स्टिल देयर. ही कुड मेक आउट दैट द बुलेट वाज देयर. ही सेड विथ कूल इंटरेस्ट, नाउ आई वंडर हाउ डीप दिस रॉक वुंड इज. सो यहाँ पे दो इंजरी थी, एक तो बुलेट की इंजरी थी और दूसरी इंजरी थी रॉक से जो चोट लगी थी उस वुंड पे. वो इफ इट इज नॉट सो डीप इट मे बी दैट आई कैन गेट द बुलेट बट द ब्लीडिंग इज नॉट सुपरफिशियल ही हैज लॉस्ट मच ब्लड. एट दिस मोमेंट हाना चोक्ड. तो इतनी सारी ब्लीडिंग देख के हाना शी चोक्ड, उसका गला फंस रहा था. ही लुक्ड अप एंड सॉ हर फेस द कलर ऑफ सल्फर. सो यू हैव एन एक्सप्रेशन ओवर हियर, एक एक्सप्रेशन है जिसका कि आप मुझे मीनिंग बताएंगे. Write it in the chat box. इस expression का क्या meaning है? I'll be waiting for your answer. The face, the color of sulfur. Okay. So इसका मतलब होता है sulfur is yellow color. So her face has turned pale. जब भी कोई बुरी गंदी चीज या डरावनी चीज हम देखते हैं तो हमारा चेहरा पीला पड़ जाता है. So this is what we refer to here, face the color of sulfur. Don't faint, he said sharply. He did not put down his exploring instrument. He instructed his wife that she shouldn't faint. And he was continuing with his work. If I stop now, the man will surely die. She clapped her hands to her mouth and leaped and ran out of the room. So the doctor is saying that don't faint here because he'll not be able to attend his wife. Because if he stops, अगर वो रुक जाता है उस टाइम पे, so what will happen? His patient will die. He is in a very critical stage. तो उसकी death हो जाएगी. So what Hannah does? She covers her mouth and then she runs towards the garden. Room से बाहर निकलती है, garden में जाती है वो. Outside in the garden, he heard her retching. So retching is vomiting. Retching का मतलब होता है vomiting. So she was vomiting, but he went on with his work. But doctor उठ के नहीं जा सकता था अपनी wife को attend करने के लिए. He was busy with his work. It will be better for her to empty her stomach, he thought. He had forgotten that, of course, she had never seen an operation. But her distress and his inability to go to her at once made him impatient and irritable with his man, with this man who lay like dead under his knife. So he wanted to help his wife but couldn't do because this man needed his attention too. And then he said that it would be better if his wife's stomach is empty. So puking, vomiting would be fine for that moment. This man, he thought, there is no reason under heaven why he should live. I told you in the beginning, मैंने आपको कल भी बोला था, the name of this chapter is The Enemy. The enemy stays enemy till the end. The doctor, if you realize, अगर आपने समझा है अभी तक, the doctor and his wife, they are doing lots of things to save this man. Operation कर रहे हैं, उसकी cleaning करी है, उसको अपने घर में लेके आए हैं. But not even for once in the entire story, you will find that this couple treats him as a friend. उसको friend कभी नहीं मान रहे हैं. He was an enemy and he'll always remain enemy for them throughout the story. That is why the title is so apt, The Enemy. Okay. अनकॉन्शियसली दिस थॉट मेड हिम रूथलेस एंड ही प्रोसीडेड स्विफ्टली। और इस बात से इरिटेट होके क्या होता है कि वो और भी तेजी से अपना काम करने में लग जाता है। दिस इज वॉट हैपन्स। Groan, he muttered. Groan if you like. I am not doing this for my own pleasure. So what happens कि वो जितनी तेजी से काम करना शुरू करता है, उसकी सर्जरी करना शुरू करता है, तो इसको पेन होने लगता है। रिमेंबर उसको एनेस्थीसिया नहीं दिया था, ठीक है, इसलिए द मैन कुड फील द पेन ही वॉज गोइंग थ्रू। तो द डॉक्टर वॉट इज सेइंग, groan, cry. Cry, तुम जितना कर सकते हो, मैं अपनी खुशी से नहीं कर रहा हूँ। In fact, I do not know why I am doing this. The door opened and there was Hannah again. So Hannah, after that retching thing, she comes back. Where is the anesthetic? She asked in a clear voice. Sadao motioned with his chin. It is as well that you came back, he said. This fellow is beginning to stir. Okay, so the man was unconscious, but he was feeling the pain now, which was going on, which he was experiencing because of the surgery going on. So Hannah was right. Hannah entered at the correct moment. It was time to give him anesthesia because the man was moving because of pain. She had the bottle and some cotton in her hand. But how should I do it? She had, remember, she had told initially ki usko nahi pata ki anesthesia dete kaise hain. So he said, simply saturate the cotton. That is, dip the cotton with this liquid. Hold it near his nostrils, Sadao replied, without delaying for one moment. The intricate detail of his work. When he breathes badly, move it away a little. So how did they put anesthesia that time? They used to soak it in cotton or usko nostril ke paas mein rakhte the. So when the patient was inhaling it, usse wo unconscious hota tha. So the precaution here was, when the patient starts breathing badly, the anesthesia in dipped in cotton should be removed from that patient, should be kept away. She crouched close to the sleeping face of the young American. It was a piteously thin face, she thought. So she was feeling pity for him. And the lips were twisted. The man was suffering, whether he knew it or not. Watching him, she wondered if the stories they heard sometimes of the suffering of prisoners were true. So it was, I told you in the beginning, the story is set, ye World War II ke backdrop mein set hai. So these people used to hear ki prisoner of war ko kaise torture karte hain. To isko dekh ke she was trying to relate ki jab bola jata hai ki prisoner of war ko torture karte hain, to kya unko isi tarah se torture kiya jata hai. Us time pe she took it as rumor, ki rumor hai, told by word of mouth and always contradicted. तो नहीं मानते थे लोग, उस पर कॉन्ट्रोडिक्शन चलती थी। इन द न्यूज़ पेपर्स द रिपोर्ट्स वर ऑलवेज दैट वेर एवर द जैपनीज आर्मीज वेंट द पीपल रिसीव देम ग्लैडली विद क्राइज ऑफ जॉय एट देयर लिबरेशन। दिस वॉज द रेपुटेशन दैट जैपनीज ट्रूप्स वर होल्डिंग फॉर देम। उनका हर जगह वेलकम किया जाता था, रेस्पेक्ट किया जाता था। बट समटाइम्स शी रिमेंबर्ड सच मैन एज जनरल तकीमा हु एट होम बीट हिज वाइफ क्रूअली। But usko the other part of the story she had known too, which was about General Takima, jo ki apni wife ko bahut cruelly maarte the. Though no one mentioned it now that he had fought so victorious battle in Manchuria, par uske bare mein koi baat nahi karta tha because he had come home as a winner. He came home with victory for the nation. If a man like that could be so cruel to a woman in his power, would he not be cruel to one like this, for instance? So she could relate and understand now ki wo rumors nahi the. Jab General Takima, jiska ki itna naam hai, itna respect hai, he used to beat his wife cruelly. So jab unke paas koi prisoner aa jata hoga, to wo us pe kya mercy dikhate honge? Bilkul bhi nahi. She hoped anxiously that this young man had not been tortured. It was at this moment that she observed deep red scars on his neck, just under the ear. So she just was hoping ki is man ko aise nahi torture kiya gaya ho. People may would have been gentle with him, but then she realizes that there were deep red scars on his neck. Uske kaan ke theek niche mein scars the. Those scars, she muttered, lifting her eyes to Sadao. But Sadao ne koi jawab nahi diya. Because at this time he felt the tip of his instrument strike against something hard. Okay, so what happens? She noticed the scars, and when she wants to talk about it, Sadao was busy doing the operation. एंड एट दैट वेरी मोमेंट द टिप ऑफ द इंस्ट्रूमेंट टच्ड समथिंग हार्ड डेंजरसली नियर द किडनी. सो व्हाट कुड इट बी, क्या हो सकता है बताओ. क्या होगा बताओ बेटा. ओके यस इट वॉज द बुलेट. सो विल स्टॉप हियर ओनली फॉर टुडे. हम यहीं पे रुकेंगे एंड फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट क्लास, कल के सेशन में रेस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट विल बी कंटिन्यूड. एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब अन अकेडमी. लेट्स क्रैक सीबीएसई एंड विल बी वेटिंग फॉर यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. कल मिलेंगे बेटा. टुमारो आई विल हैव वन क्लास एट 4:30 एंड द अदर वन एट 5:30. आई विल बी पोस्टिंग द लिंक. आप अन अकेडमी लेट्स क्रैक सीबीएसई पे उसको ढूंढ भी सकते हैं इन द नेम ऑफ डॉक्टर यामिनी. सो सी यू टुमारो. हैव अ नाइस डे. स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ, टेक केयर. ऑल द बेस्ट. थैंक यू सो मच.